Senator, ito, magtapatan po tayo. May kinakatakutan po ba kayo sa ICC? Sa totoo lang.
Karen, ikaw, hindi ka ba takot na mapasok sa kulungan?
May nagawa ba kayo? Naniniwala kayo?
Ay, para ibang istorya yan. Ibang usapan yan. Ibang usapan yan. Bakit lahat mo ba ng nakakulo ngayon ay talagang may kasalanan? Hindi naman. Hindi ako takot na sabihin mo mayroon akong na-commit na kasalanan. No. Takot ako na makulong dahil kawawa yung mga apo ko, hindi ko na makikita. Yun lang ang akin. Makulong ka. Buti kung makulong ka lang dito sa Pilipinas, ikukulong ka doon sa Daheg. Ano ngayon? Paano makabisita yung mga apo mo? They will grow up lololess. So, kawawa naman yung mga apo ko. I love my apo so much.
Pero para halimbawa lang po ito, no, hypothetical.
Yes, yes.
Para diba, hypothetical lang po ito.
Opo.
Para magawa ng ICC, halimbawa, no, magkaroon ng conviction, una nasa probe pa lang eh. So, halimbawa po, hindi pa conviction, halimbawa magkaroon ng arrest warrant, tapos magkaroon ng hearing. Hindi po yun magagawa ng ICC kung hindi po yun papayagan ng Pangulo ng Pilipinas. Naniniwala po ba kayo na papayagan yun ng Pangulo ng Pilipinas?
Hindi. Hindi, because klaro naman sinabi niya. Yung investigation ng pangalang, inaayawan na niya. How much more yung implementation ng arrest warrant? Paano niya papayagan niya na hindi ka niya pinayagan yung investigation? It follows.
All right. Now, if the ICC is in the Philippines, because we are receiving also information that they're already here, right? May ganung impormasyon din, nandito na sila. Kung tapos na ang investigasyon ng ICC, ano po ang gagawin ninyo? May plano po ba kayo?
Very clear naman. Alam mo, Karen, na whether or not nakagawa sila ng investigasyon or what, once sinabi ng Pangulo na hindi tayo mag-cooperate sa kanila because they are a threat to our sovereignty, then I am only a citizen of this republic. I will follow what the president, what is the stand of the president. Pero kung sinabi ng presidente na papasokin ang ICC, ipakulong si Bato, then sino ako para umayaw? O ipakulong niyo, wala ka naman makipagira ako sa gobyerno. Hindi man ako pwede makipagira pag-arestuhin ako ng pulis.
Pero papayag ka doon? Ako. So, I mean, tanong ko lang, you are a sitting senator.
Ha?
You are a sitting senator.
Well, it depends kung ang liderato ng Senado ay ayaw na akong i-turn over sa ICC. And very clear, sinabi na aming Senate President, ICC cannot touch you. Just in case mayroong warrant of arrest na ipapalabas. Hindi sila makakapasok sa Senado para kunin ka. So, ano ngayon ang gagawin ng ICC?
Okay. All right. Now let's move on to the case of the ICC itself. Hindi ko natatanungin kung pananaw nyo may ginawa kayong mali. Sinagot nyo na po yun, di ba? Sinabi nyo, wala akong ginawang mali. Pero naniniwala po ba kayo na may basihan ang ICC sa pagdating sa pagkuha ng detalye, impormasyon sa mga namatay sa drug war na posibleng hindi naman tunay na nagbebenta ng droga, mga biktima lang sila? Could it be possible that the drug war under the Duterte administration, could it be possible, Senator, that it went overboard, that it victimized ordinary people?
Karen, yung sinasabi mong overboard, matagal na naman natin pinag-usapan yan na merong nag-abuso ng mga pulis. Yun ay kinituhan. Sila ngayon ay nagkaharap ng kaso. At yung iba, going on investigation. Settled, well settled issue na yan. Pero yung sinabi mo na yung meron bang basihan ang ICC sa ganito, ganun, I categorically say no. Wala nga basihan yung local courts natin, yung ICC pa. Eh, kung ano makukuha ng ICC, nakukuha na rin yan ng local courts natin, functioning naman ang ating local courts. O may nagpapayal ng kaso, kung na-dismiss yan, dumaan yan sa due process, di ba? May nagkaso man. O kung wala man nagkaso, then, ibig sabihin, ayaw nila magkaso dahil wala silang alam nila where they stand. Legal standing nila kung may laban ba o hindi. So, basic yun eh, basic. Bakit? Paano yan? makakuha ng ebidensya ang ICC tapos ang local courts natin hindi, anong ating DOJ hindi. Wow, napakalaking sampal naman yan sa ating DOJ at sa ating mga korte, no? Kung wala tayong makukuha, kung meron man talaga, tapos yung iba makakuha. So kung makakuha man ang ICC, tapos ang ating mga local courts hindi nakakuha, ibig sabihin, mga kuha niyan, mga fabricated na ebidensya yan. Hindi yan, it will not stand even in the standards of our local courts.
Okay. All right. To close this issue, two more questions.
Yes.
Would you ever, ever surrender yourself to the ICC at any point?
Never, 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 never. Yeah. Very clear, sinabi ng ating Pangulo na hindi tayo mag-cooperate with the ICC. And I am a good citizen of this republic. I am just following observing the stand of the president. So, bakit ako magpapahuli? Ayaw nga na Pangulo eh.
But let's say, hypothetically, let's say the president had a different stand. Ikaw ba, sir, ang tao na magtatago ka na lang sa bundok kesa mag-surrender sa ICC?
Uy, Karen, sabi ko nga, I am a good citizen of this republic. Kapag sinabi ng Pangulo na ipakulong si Bato, magpapakulong ako. Bakit ako makipag-ira? Useless. Bakit ako magtago? Kita mo yung ulo ko. Kilalang kilala ito pong Pilipinas. Hindi ako makapagtago, Karen. Hindi ako makapagtago. Kaya useless. It will okay. be it would be an exercise in futility. So harapin mo na lang kung sinabi ng gobyerno natin na harapin mo.
All right. Okay.
Matigas ang ulo.
All right. My last question on this issue is, what is your message to President Marcos Jr.? Are you sensing, if I can connect it, are you sensing that the change right now that Malacanang is saying they're now open, the ICC may visit, but the government won't cooperate, but they may visit. You said, kanina, that they were softening. You felt they were softening. Are you seeing this as something political? Are you sensing something political here?
No. Very clear naman yung latest. Basihan natin yung latest. Kumbaga sa paggawa ng batas, the latest law would amend all previous laws. No. So yung existing law ngayon, yung existing declaration ng ating Pangulo is very clear. So wala akong duda. Wala akong duda. However, this pro-ICC people will sugarcoat everything just to suit their desires. Nada. Wala. Never. Wala kayo maasahan from this government na yung gustuhan ninyo na si citizen Duterte at citizen Bato ay makulong. Bye-bye. Goodbye to your hopes.
Okay. But then, frankly speaking, I mean, let me just ask you, if Senator Bato de la Rosa has nothing to fear, if you have nothing to hide, why wouldn't you face or want the ICC to frankly just investigate, see what they have? What is it? I mean, the ordinary citizen wants the ICC. I mean, not all.
Karen, bakit ako magmatigas ang ulo, no? Sabi ko nga sa iyo, I am a good citizen of this republic. Sinabi ng ating Pangulo na hindi tayo mag-cooperate. Eh bakit ako mag-cooperate? Sinabi ng ating gobyerno na huwag tayo mag-cooperate because ICC is a threat to our sovereignty. Ewan ko bakit itong mga bleeding hearts na gustong-gustong isurrender yung ating sovereignty doon sa foreign bodies. And then nila, hindi sila nagmamahal sa ating bansa. They do not love this country. They gustong-gusto lang isurrender at gusto nilang babastusin yung ating mga korte, ang ating Supreme Court. Dahil gusto talaga yung pumasok. Functioning yung ating judicial system dito. Yung ating korte ay gumagana. Eh bakit naman ganun ang pag-iisip natin? Well, I don't know this kind of Filipinos. Ay siguro itong mga Pilipino na ito ay dapat pakantahin natin ng 1,000 times ng Bayang Magiliw.
Oo. Yung ating, I just wanted to ask you. But no, the ICC essentially hears crimes against humanity. So, I mean, for the record, I have yet to see our courts actually make a decision on a crime against humanity. So, they don't really hear personal
Karen, 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 bakit
lawyer.
ka? Bakit ka maghanap ng crimes against humanity na wala man talaga nangyayari? Wala nga hindi nga maka-prove ng simple homicide at murder yung mga accusers na yan? Hindi ka maka-prove ng simple homicide at murder. Why elevate your thinking towards crime against humanity? You're daydreaming. You're daydreaming, Karen. Maghanap kayo ng crimes against humanity. Ha?
All right, but the crimes against humanity. Yeah, all right. I just wanted to say the reason I brought up that the ICC is investigating this is because of the number of deaths in the drug war. So then it falls under the crimes against humanity, more than 5,000 deaths. I mean, that's the PNP records, I believe. The other records show 12,000, but the PNP records, it's still in the thousands.
Well, lahat naman yan ng recorded ng PNP, na may record ang DOJ, may record ang ating mga korte as far as cases filed. Andiyan naman yan lahat, isa-isahin natin. Huwag natin ilump natin lahat para sa... Andiyan ang pulis na namatay, di ba? Crimes against humanity yan. Kahit pulis ang namatay, crimes against humanity ba yan? Hindi ha. Ilan dyan ang mga pinatay ng mga drug lord? Crimes against humanity ba yan? Hindi. So, ito nga, balik tayo sa basic. Yung Rome Statute nagsasabi, yung kanilang Article 1, na sila ay makakapasok lamang, ang ICC, pwede makikialam if the local jurisdiction is not willing or is not capable of conducting investigation. Kaya naman gumagana ang investigation, gumagana ating mga korte, eh bakit pa sila mag-insist na pumasok? Dahil sa prodding ng mga taong nasa likod na galit kay Duterte. Kasama na dyan yung mga drug lords na nawala ng negosyo dahil sa war on drugs.
All right, okay. Now let's move on from this topic.
Yes.
Just to close it, do you have a message for President Marcos Jr.?
Well, my message to the President. Mr. President, I salute your bold statements. Ikaw ang presidente na may bayag at may isang salita. Maraming salamat, Mr. President.
Okay, moving on to another issue. So all senators have actually signed a resolution against the People's Initiative. Okay? First of all, with this push for changing the charter, are you still for charter change, Senator Dela Rosa, this particular time? Because you were open to charter change during former President Duterte's time. Etong version na ito, are you open to changing the charter?
No.
At
no.
all? Even
because,
the economic provisions?
Economic provisions, wala akong problema. Ang problema lang dyan kasi, wrong move yung kanilang ginawang People's Initiative. Dahil from the very start, meron ng ill motive eh. Meron ng bad faith yung ginagawa nila. Dahil from the very start pala ng PI nila, gusto na nilang ikapon yung Senado. Gusto na nilang gawing insignificant ang Senado by amending yung pinaka-amendment nila sa kanilang PI, no? Congress voting as one or voting jointly. Paano na kami ngayon makakaupos sa aming, kung halimbawa, yung ibang mga congressman dyan, may isasaksak ng mga amendments na hindi namin gusto dahil ito yung mga makakasira sa ating bansa or ito yung mga self-serving na mga amendments. Paano kami makakaupos? 24 na lang kami as against 318. So talagang overpowered kami, overruled, outvoted palagi kung magkakaroon ng voting as one. So may bad faith na from the very to start with, no? To begin with, that PI is tainted with bad faith.
But are you in favor of changing the charter provisions through a constituent assembly?
Yes, particularly yung economic provisions para gaganda yung takbo ng ating bansa dahil nga simple lang naman yung hinihingi natin yung economic provisions dagdagan lang ng sa dulo ng unless otherwise provided by law so to make it para maganda yung ating ekonomiya So yun lang naman ang kuha natin, wala problema. Pero pagdating na doon sa pasukan na ng mga political amendments na tanggalin yung term limits, na eh, hindi ko papayag yan eh. Dahil sila na lang magpe-perpetuate yan sa power hanggang forever and ever, hanggat gusto nilang magiging congressman, hanggat gusto nila maging gobernador, mayor, sila na lang, dahil sila may hawak ng power, sila may hawak ng pera.
All right. Okay. I want to know the pulse of the Senate on this, because Senator Joel Villanueva, I think he issued a statement saying that senators are no longer interested in amending the economic provisions. So this is something new to me, because I know there are some senators who want to amend the economic provisions. But what is the pulse among your colleagues? Yung mga kasamahan niyo po ba? Gusto ba nilang baguhin ang economic provisions pa rin? Or nagbago na po ito, Senator?
As of now, hindi namin napag-usapan yan. No? Napag-usapan lang namin yan na previously. Pero as of now, nakatutok talaga kami dyan sa PI na yan. Na how to counter that PI, dahil very, very, very damaging yan on our part. No, wala na kaming voice. No? Wala na kaming boses pagdating sa pag-amend ng konstitusyon. So diyan kami nakatutok ngayon. Kailangan, we have to stop it.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much, Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa. Okay, wait, before I close, there's another question here. Okay, let me just ask this. You also said how the House Speaker could be behind the People's Initiative. Davao del Norte lawmaker Pantaleon Alvarez, he was on Headstart the other day, he said the same. How credible is the information you're receiving? Because the lower house has, the majority has repeatedly denied it, that the speaker is behind the People's Initiative.
Baka sila na lang, Karen, ang hindi nakakaalam na the people behind this PI are they themselves, yung liderato ng Kongreso. Baka sila lang hindi nakakaalam. Alam na lang taong bayan, lahat ng tao alam na na yung mga chief of staff, mga staff ng mga congressman, sila ang naglalakad, sila ang umiikot. Baka ang Congress na lang hindi nakakaalam na ang inisyatibo pala ay nanggagaling sa kanila. So we were not born yesterday, Karen. We were not born yesterday.
So you believe, you really believe the House Speaker? Do you
yes.
believe the House Speaker was behind it, funding the People's Initiative?
Sino pa?
Okay, now Vice President Sara Duterte, what are her midterm plans? She said she'll run in the next elections. That would be 2025. She's a sitting vice president right now. Have you spoken to her?
Not yet, Karen, about that issue. Hindi pa kami nag-usap. Usapan tungkol diyan.
Okay, but would you want, what would you advise the vice president? Because there are different talks that are circulating. She might run for the Senate. There are even talks she might run for Quezon City Mayor. I mean, it's really going from left to right to left field, right? So anong narinig po ninyo?
Wala pa kong narinig. No? Basta ako, whatever her wishes are, I'm here to support her.
Oo.
Ganyan ako okay. Ka-supportive sa ating Vice President. Kung ano mang gusto niya, andito lang ako sa likuran mo, ma'am, at sumusuporta sa'yo.
Mm-mm. Now, are you running for re-election yourself?
Yes, Karen, yes.
Okay, right, yeah, okay, fine. Now, moving forward, just moving on to a bigger political question here. When I interviewed Representative Alvarez, he says he's now in good terms with former President Duterte, and to a degree, even with Vice President Sara Duterte, he said even if they were in opposite sides during the last elections, is he'd rather support her because she's a Mindanaoan. Is it right to say na mas solid ngayon kayong mga Duterte allies? You, the former President, Sara, and now former Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez? Are you all now united more than ever?
Natural tendency yan, Karen. Eh. Pag nakita mo yung isang kapwa mo Mindanaoan, binubugbog, ay talaga mag-consolidate yan lahat at magsusuporta. Mag-guan yan, mag-consolidate yan ng forces. Dahil kinakawawa nyo kami, sige nga, we will fight. Madali lang magkaisa yung mga taga Mindanao, Karen. Dahil for a very long time, matagal na kami neglected doon sa Mindanao. Madali lang kami magkakaisa. Dahil matagal ng panahon na neglected ang Mindanao pagdating sa development.
Okay. All right. And what are you seeing in the future? Is this another Marcos Romualdez Duterte face-off?
Well, too early to tell. Kasi no, marami pa pwede mangyayari yan along the way. So let's just observe. Kung yan ang nakita mo ngayon na magiging contending parties, contending groups towards the end. Possibly yan, pero as I've said, marami pang pwede mangyari. Yung nga, yung isang issue dyan, yung sinabi mo pa na his BP Indaysara is planning to run this midterm election. Hindi pa alam kung as a senator or as a mayor of Davao, hindi pa natin alam. So marami mangyayari along the way.
All right. Okay. Well, on that note, I want to thank you so much for being with me today, as always. Thank you so much, Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. Maraming salamat.
As always.